Hello friends, welcome back to Shomu's Biology. We've been talking about lately regarding the referencing systems. We've been seeing how to apply for a research grant, how to write a research proposal, and we have already talked about the Harvard referencing system, Vancouver referencing system, MLA, as well as APA style referencing system. Now the question is, I got a reply from many of my students that we understood about the referencing system, we know what is the importance of referencing, but while we are writing research paper, it was so tedious because we need to study all the research paper, derive information, comprehend it, and finally analyze it to write a review research article based on that. So it's always a time consuming. Based on that, how can we finish the referencing, which is really, really tedious to do it manually? Now, the answer to it is that nowadays you don't need to even do the referencing manually. You know, you need to know the basis of the referencing so that you can construct the references on your own, but still you never need to manually reference every single detail. You can use free tools to reference your article, to reference your journal publications, as well as to reference your any of the articles from the book, website, or journal sources. So I'm going to share with you two important sources, free sources, which you can use to reference both websites as well as the journal. So I'll also put two examples of that to explain how to use them. The first tool, and this is the most important one that I generally prefer to use, is www.citethisforme.com. This website is really, really good for the researchers who are willing to write research papers. It will reduce your headache and time constraint a huge amount. So very thankful for developing this website. It's fantastic, and I don't think there is any limit because I've used this a couple of times. But even though there is a limit, even though it's paying, I generally have a free account there to continue. But if even it is a paid platform, I think based on the time that it saves you from, it is the best thing to go with. I'll show you how to cite the different research papers with the help of this tool. And the second one is www.mendeley.com. Now Mendeley is another website, and it's also, they sell a software. You can use that software which can be combined with your Microsoft Word, and while you're writing something in the Word, you can also check the referencing pattern in there. But it reads a kind of training. The Mendeley works better the more you work with Mendeley. But I personally prefer myself to go with Cite This For Me. I'll also show you both Cite This For Me as well as Mendeley. Although you can find out the details about every single referencing system with the help of this link, mendeley.com/guides, regarding all the different referencing system with detailed information about them. That's very important. But in this video, I'm going to share you how to reference website pages as well as research articles with the help of Cite This For Me. So let me go to explain this Cite This For Me. So let me first go inside and website. Let's say this is the website, Cite This For Me. So go inside Cite This For Me, and this is my dashboard. You can see I already cited two different information. So I'm going to show you how exactly you will cite a research paper first, and then I'll show how to cite a website. So here in this case, we cite two things, journal and website. How exactly I'm showing you that? So you can see that this interface is something like the Microsoft Word interface kind of thing. So here it says add new reference. In add new reference, you click and it will redirect you to go there somewhere. This website, journal, book, and more. Now among this, you should create, if you are citing any website, you click on website. If you're citing a journal, if you're citing a book, then you click book, and then journal, it will open up this page. So once we are in this page, you need to put either the title of the journal or a DOI of the journal. Okay, so in this case, let's say this is the article that we're talking about. Okay, so let me open this up. Let's say you are writing a research paper, and during writing a review, you find out that this research paper found to be really important. You took many information from this research paper, and you need to cite this paper in a correct manner. And this is the title, Pedigree Analysis of Children with Phonology Disorders. So just simply take and copy that title, and you put that title and enter search in the Cite This For Me. So you got that, Pedigree Analysis of Children with Phonology Disorders, B. Lewis, 1992. You should always check that one out. See, this is B. Lewis, Barbara Lewis, 1992. This is the correct one. So once you find the list of informations, among them you see this is the correct one by B. Lewis, you enter cite. And you, the moment you click cite, they will pop up some information. The author name, Barbara A. Lewis. Year published 1992. Article name, Pedigree Analysis of Children with Phonology Disorders. Journal name, Journal of Learning Disabilities. You can also check that one out in this case. And issue number 9, volume number 25, page number 586 to 597. You don't need to do anything. They will just scrap the whole internet and find these details. And you see, yes, this is the correct details. Enter, continue. And there comes everything details. Now, if some details need to be altered, you can alter that manually. And if you want to put the URL, let's say this is the URL. So we just copy this URL and place the URL there. And the access date, let's say today is the access date. So this is 7. So let's say the date is 7, month 9, September, year 2018. So let's put the year 2018. These are the two things which are optional to mention, the URL of the database as well as the access date. But in this case, we are putting it, so we'll put it manually. If you don't need to put it, it's fine. Then add complete citation. And there you go. They put the complete citation here, which is highlighted in yellow. This is the complete citation based on which model. You can see Chicago style. You can see which style this is actually giving you. Chicago style. This is the Chicago style. This is the total reference, so you just copy it. This will be your bibliography for the Chicago style referencing. Cross it out. Let's take a word page. In this word page, let's put it. This is how the referencing will go. And the best way, if you want to put it without the highlight, just paste it like this. That's how it goes. This is the reference in the Chicago style. Remember, this is Chicago style. And if you want to get this information in Vancouver style, what you should do, let's go back. Then simply click this drop down. And from there, you click Vancouver. So you go there and you'll find out Vancouver. Okay, so Vancouver click. And this information already altered. So let's select this and Vancouver. So you see this information now in Vancouver. So this is how should put. So copy it, place it in a Vancouver style. This is the Vancouver style. Okay, so this sequence, based on which sequence you actually put them, but this is Vancouver style. Now if you want to put this information with Harvard style referencing, then simply again select this and then again select Harvard. See, now your reference style is converted to Harvard. So this will be your Harvard style referencing. And not only they will just put you the reference, but also they will put you in-text referencing in there. See, the in-text for Harvard, Lewis, 1992. For Vancouver, there is difference. So simply you can copy the whole thing from there with in-text referencing and all the details. Put it there. This is the Harvard style referencing, right? And if you want to get it in APA style, you can get it too. Just select the one. And again, APS style. This is APS 6th edition, and you get it in the APS style. See, this is the APS style referencing. Copy it, and again, whenever you need to paste it, just paste the APS style referencing. This is the APS style referencing. And then again, if you need to find it in the MLA style, again, the same process. And let's say you're searching it for many other options, all the references will be placed in your dashboard. In this case, I searched 3 different options. That's why 3 separate references are shown here. You can check it for grammar, or you can simply delete the existing reference like this. Okay, it can be easy. Delete it like this. Okay, so stay tuned on only one. So now you also select, let's say MLA style, MLA 7th or 8th, let's say 8th edition MLA. And this will be your MLA style referencing. Copy it, place it like this. Okay, so this is it. You can see it's how easy, it's so much easy to get the information like this with the help of cite this for me. Okay, now this is regarding the reference of journal. Now if you want to reference a website, you need to again click add new reference. It will open up the page again, and again in this case you should put click website. And in the website section, you should put the URL of the website. But you know, I tried it many times, putting URL of exact page will help. But not always it's helpful, because websites are not really maintained in a sequential and proper structural manner like journals. So if you put the website URL, they may not give you a correct range of information always. So I prefer to put manually. So let's say I'm looking at my website of shomusbiology.com. In that shomusbiology.com, we are looking at an article, a guide to solve pedigree problems. So that's what we are will be checking. So let's look at here. The first name of the author is Suman. So let me just write the name. Last name of the author, Bhattacharji. The website published, let's say the article publishing date is also visible in the website, which is 2017. Let's write it, page title. This, sorry, it's simply, let me copy this. A guide to solve pedigree problems. Let's say this is the page, website name. Let's write that manually, Shomu's Biology. Publisher name, again, Weebly is the website publisher. So let's mention Weebly. URL, HTTP, you don't need to mention because it will be automatically added. So simply write www.shomusbiology.com. And then the date access, let's say today is the date, so 7th September 2018. So then add complete citation. And there we go. The citation is provided in MLA 8. So this is the citation. This will be your bibliography for MLA. So for website, this is the MLA style referencing. Now the same way you can change the referencing style to Harvard. If you do the Harvard referencing style, click on Harvard and it is changed. See, again copy. This is Harvard style referencing. So that's how easy it is to reference journal pages as well as website. You know, in this case, this is my website, so I know all the details regarding author, publisher. So if it's a different website, be sure to find out the exact page where the article is present and put that page like this article source, so that you get a complete information. And even if you are failed to get a complete information, you need to fill that gap manually to get a complete information of the reference, because if you fail to put complete information, your reference will be incomplete and it will not be good. Okay, so remember to use Cite This For Me. It's a very good software online that can give you a huge time saver regarding the referencing of your research paper. Okay, in the next video we'll talk about Grammarly, as well as we'll be talking about the Mendeley, how to reference them with Mendeley, and we'll also talk about Grammarly and what Grammarly does and how to use Grammarly as well. So that's all about today's lecture. Remember, we started talking about different referencing systems, and we know these are the two referencing tools, especially www.citethisforme works very, very good for us. Okay, so if you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, obviously subscribe to my channel to get more and more interesting videos like that. Thank you.